Good morning, students. Today we will continue with the poem Butterfly Laughter, composed by Catherine Mansfield. In the previous session, we have discussed word meanings, phrases, and explanation of the first stanza. In this video, we will discuss word meanings, phrases, explanation of second stanza, plus central idea of the poem. Now students, open your Fragrance English Reader book at page number 9. Before proceeding further, let us recapitulate what we have discussed earlier in the poem. We have discussed that the poet speaks of a blue butterfly that was painted in the middle of their porridge plates. The poet, together with her siblings, competed every morning to see who was the first to reach the butterfly and finish the porridge. But their grandmother always told them jokingly not to eat the poor butterfly, and this made them laugh. Now students, let us read the second stanza of the poem. Always she said it, and always it started us laughing. It seemed such a sweet little joke. I was certain that one fine morning the butterfly would fly out of our plates, laughing the teeniest laugh in the world, and perch on the grandmother's lap. Now students, mark word meanings and phrases in this stanza. Underline the word laughing, and the meaning is smiling. Next word is certain, and the breakup of the word is certain, and the meaning is sure. Next word is teeniest. The breakup of the word is teeniest, and the meaning is smallest. And next word is perch, and the meaning is to sit. Last word is lap, and the meaning of the word is the upper part of our legs when we sit down. Now students, mark phrases of our plates. Hamari plato mein. In the world, संसार में, on the grandmother's lap, दादी माँ की गोद में. Now students, we will discuss explanation. Let us read the lines again. Always she said it, and always it started us laughing. It seemed such a sweet little joke. In this stanza, the poet says that whenever she with her siblings came each morning to eat the porridge, their grandmother always repeated the same words, jokingly, that not to eat the poor butterfly. So students, why did the children laugh? The children laughed when their grandmother told them jokingly not to eat the poor butterfly. She always said so, and every time this made them laugh. It was such a sweet little joke for them. Come to the next lines. I was certain that one fine morning the butterfly would fly out of our plates, laughing the teeniest laugh in the world, and perch on the grandmother's lap. In these lines, the poet was sure that one day the butterfly painted on the plates would come to life and fly out of their plates. Then it would sit on their grandmother's lap with the sweetest smile of the world. Now students, I hope that the explanation of second stanza is clear to everyone. And on the basis of second stanza, you will be able to answer question number 4, why did the children laugh? And question number 5, I was certain that one fine morning the butterfly would fly out of our plates. What does the poet mean by these lines? Option A, one day the butterfly painted on the plate would come to life and fly away. Option B, one morning a live butterfly would come from outside and sit on the plate. Option C, one day the butterfly will learn how to fly. Here you have to tick the correct answer. Now students, we will discuss the central idea of the poem. But before proceeding, I would like to tell you what central idea is. Central idea is the most important and main idea of the poem. Now students, let us discuss central idea. Students, what brings a smile on our face? A sweet little joke brings smile on our face. What can a sweet little joke do? A sweet little joke can create wonders. How did the poet's grandmother serve breakfast to the children? The poet's grandmother served breakfast to the children with a pinch of laughter. And why did the children burst into laughter? The children burst into laughter when their grandmother told them not to eat the butterfly painted on the plates. So students, our central idea would be the poem brings home the idea that a sweet little joke can create wonders. The poet's grandmother always served them breakfast with a pinch of laughter. The moment she tells the children not to eat the butterfly painted on the plates, they burst into laughter. Now students, using the highlighted keywords, write down the central idea on your copy in your own words. So students, in today's video, we have discussed word meanings, phrases, explanation of second stanza and central idea of the poem. Students, you have to read the poem again and again for better understanding. Thank you.